Good afternoon, everyone. How the fuck are you guys doing? Doing pretty goddamn good. Good afternoon to you, Vaughn Helton. I got your PM, and I saw that you put my name in the tags of your most recent video, and I took that to mean that you wanted my feedback, right? And so I'm gonna give it. I'm gonna give you my feedback. I don't think you're gonna enjoy it. And your wake up call failed miserably on me. I gotta tell you. So for all of you that want to watch what I'm replying to, go ahead, it's yeah. Check it out. Watch as much as you can stomach, and then come back here and finish the rest of what will hopefully be a quick video reply, right? Vaughn, you have, congratulations, you have epitomized the stereotypical ignorant redneck in this video more than you ever have in the past. I gotta tell you, your video is just blind bigotry at its best. First thing you say in your video is that, well, you took a little trip around YouTube and you were looking around and you saw that nobody else was about, or nobody else said what you were about to say, and you couldn't figure out why. Because, well, I'm gonna go ahead and let you in on a little secret. The reason nobody else actually attempted to make the arguments that you did in your video is because your arguments are fucking stupid. I'm just gonna come out and tell you that your arguments are fucking dumb, right? And the reason that nobody's making the arguments that you made is because they don't want to make a complete fucking dumbass out of themselves in front of thousands of people, potentially thousands of people, right? They don't want to make an ass of themselves, so they just go ahead and avoid that by not making the argument you did in the video I'm replying to now. Now, what is the argument you're making? Let me go ahead and tell you what the best argument against the New York mosque is, okay? The best argument against it is, it's going to offend a lot of people and hurt some people's feelings. That's it. That's the best argument, right? And it's a complete appeal to emotion. But in no way is that an excuse to use the state as your tool to enforce your fucking feelings and emotions about something on another group of people, right? If that were legal, if that were something you could actually do in this country, if I could use the state to tear down the churches all around me up the fucking road, goddamn boy, wow, wouldn't that be, what a great place that would be to live, where all you had to do was be offended by a church and you could have the motherfucker torn down, or you could keep Christians from building a youth center in the neighborhood. Wouldn't that be great? Wouldn't that be fucking awesome? Wouldn't it be the greatest country in the world? Wow, I can't wait to live in a society where if I offend someone, they can use the state to tell me to fuck off and that I don't have the right to fucking construct a building devoted to an ideology they don't like. I don't have the right to wear a t-shirt when I'm walking up the sidewalk that says, fuck you and your mother, whatever. You get the idea. You get why what you're proposing is dangerous and it's completely anti-freedom, which is funny because I thought you were a guy that was sort of into that kind of thing. I mean, you're all for your freedom to protect yourself against people you don't like, but you're not for the other part. You know, you're not for the freedom for somebody else to fucking construct a building devoted to an ideology that you don't like. See, that's the difference, Vaughn, between you and me, is that I don't want to use the state to impose my fucking feelings on other people because, well, that would be a little fascist, Vaughn. That's what that would be. Now, the reason you're saying that we should use the state in this way to prevent these evil, wicked Muslims from building their den of sin in New York, right? It's because they're all crazy. It's an ideology of people that want to slit my throat from ear to ear and rape your wife and kill your kids, and it's going to be chaos. They'll build the mosque on Wednesday, and by Friday they'll be kicking down our doors and fucking cutting our throats and raping our women and killing our children and converting them all to Islam. Oh, the humanity! Are you fucking kidding me, Vaughn? Do you see the missteps in logic? Do you see how logic is completely lacking from your argument, right? It starts like, you know, ideology devoted to hatred, which Christianity is also, by the way, a hate-filled ideology. I know you don't see it that way. I know you don't like to hear it, but it's true, so I kind of got to say it. And I'm surrounded by buildings devoted to a hateful ideology, yet I'm still alive. I'm still alive. Oh, wait, because they're not Muslims. Maybe it slipped your mind that we have laws against rape and murder and silly little, you know, misdemeanors like that. We have laws that protect people from being fucking murdered and raped, right? So even if an ideology is hate-filled, the law doesn't protect your right to act on your psychotic hatred. And it's a good fucking thing, too. Because if the law did protect people that wanted to murder people in the name of God, my fucking ass would have been dead a long time ago for supporting abortion and saying that religion is a hate, or Christianity is a hate-filled ideology. Fucking, Timmy Thompson, the fucking devout Christian up the road, would have shot me in the back of the fucking head decades ago. Oh, yeah, but wait, he can't, because there's kind of that whole electric chair death penalty prison ass rape thing. You know, the whole deterrent factor, you know, law that says you probably shouldn't do that or we're going to throw you in prison, things like that. So what is it you think is going to happen? They build the mosque on Wednesday, and I'm getting fucked up the ass by Ahmed on Friday. I mean, is that really your argument? What a dumb fucking video. And you say, well, it's a Muslim love fest over there. It's nothing but a Muslim love fest. No, Vaughn, it's a freedom love fest, right? I don't give a fuck if you what you believe, how psychotic your fucking religion is, so long as I don't have to be a part of it, and you stay the fuck away from me. And you don't slit my throat and fucking rape my wife or girlfriend or fucking throw my, you know, whatever it is you think the evil Muslims are going to do. I mean, you really do think that, Vaughn, don't you? You really think they build the mosque and then Ahmed's going to run up on me with a scimitar and cut my throat, and you're calling me stupid? Here's the order of operation to consider for the future, right? Think, then make a video. One more time. Think, then make a video. I support Islam because I support someone else's freedom to practice it. Well, by that logic, Vaughn, I support every fucking religion in the world, and I'm just a sympathizer with the pagans and the Christians and the Muslims and the Jews. I fucking believe everything they do because I don't want the state to tell them they can't believe it or practice it. That's brilliant logic, Vaughn. I maybe this wasn't the kind of reply you were looking for, but there it is, dude. Terrible video. Horrible fucking video. But have a great day anyway, man. Peace.